You could say the device resembles a cross between a time machine, a relic of heavy industry, and a kitchen on steroids.
Yeah, so this is a vacuum chamber, and this is where we do the laser MBE. So the laser is actually over here in that large box where you see the danger sign. And the laser comes out of a small window in the front here and then travels through this. There's a series of mirrors and paths into the actual vacuum chamber. And so we keep the vacuum chamber at a very low pressure. It's probably 10 to the minus 7 torr. And we keep our samples in here. And we also put our targets or whatever materials we're trying to interact with the laser in there.
But scientists are using it to create a new state of carbon. That's right, carbon, one of the most common elements on the planet. But this state is not found in nature.
Because it's really new to the scientific world, and the field is going to make a really good impact in the near future in the semiconductor industry.
It's called Q-carbon. This is what it looks like, and the creation of Q-carbon is a scientific discovery in the purest sense of the word. This weird new type of carbon is harder and brighter than diamond, and it wasn't supposed to be here.
The first time when we got the result, we were really happy about it, and then we tried many tests on those things, and we found that they are really new stuff in the scientific world.
So let's go back to that image of Q carbon.
First we make it, then we check, double check, and we must be very sure.
The research team at North Carolina State University was studying how to make diamonds in the lab without the extreme temperatures and the pressures that are required in nature. They've been working on the problem for decades, but this time, at room temperature, they blasted carbon with a laser.
We heat up carbon so high for a very short time, and this carbon becomes a metal. And so it packs up really close, and then we quench it. And by quenching, we can directly convert into diamond, or we can create this new phase, which is called Q phase, which has a very interesting properties. Because this Q phase, since the carbon atoms got packed so closely, their distance, nearest neighbor distance, is smaller than in diamond. So this material is harder than diamond.
The laser turns the carbon into a puddle of metal, which is then quickly cooled.
Because we want to do it very fast. These are 20 nanosecond lasers. And in 200 nanoseconds, the whole thing is completed in 200 nanoseconds, which is 1/5 of a microsecond. 1/5 of a millionth of a second, we complete this process. During that time, we put in energy equivalent to 20 nuclear reactors. The power we put in is so much.
And it's the speed of the process that essentially fools Mother Nature. The melted carbon means the bonds between atoms are shortened. The quick cooling keeps those bonds close, which makes Q-carbon super dense and super hard. It is harder than diamond, and those atomic changes also mean Q-carbon emits a small amount of light. It turns out that new state of carbon is also magnetic.
Because there's so much potential in cutting tools, jewels, power systems, the list goes on and on. So you've got a new way of making carbon at much lower temperatures than ever, which is the scientific, wow factor, but also the technological, manufacturing impacts.
But for now, researchers are concentrating on making diamonds. Currently, the diamonds are very small. The largest is about 70 microns wide. That's about the width of a human hair. Researchers hope to make larger diamonds, which can be used in electronics and industry and medical devices.
And that's why we call it room temperature processing, because this overall increase in temperature is less than 5 degrees. Because it's 1/5 of a microsecond, it's for sure short, that we can manipulate atoms in that much time and create all these exotic materials.